Hey guys, it's Embers here and I'm back with a new video. Today we're gonna play some more pit games, and on the first game I decided to go bow tech. It's maybe a bit weak against grouped regrow lets, but yeah, let's see how the game is going on. I'm gonna start here with a tech shooter. And yeah, you could also start with a boat, but yeah, it's both okay. And my enemy looks like he's going for a heli play, so I'm gonna pressure him early on with group reds and don't let him farm up. So yeah, and today we gonna play with normal speed. Some of you asked for, yeah, not the speed ones, so I'm gonna try this out and check how your feedback is. And yeah, I have no problem to swap sometimes to have the speed with only music or sometimes with commentary. Yeah, I know my commentary is not the best, or let's say my English is not the best, but I'm gonna try. And I have enough space to improve. He didn't upgrade his heli, he just let him on 0-0. So I decided to just balloon boost with blues and pinks. And yeah, he was way too greedy. So our second map is Frozen River. I decided to go for boat wizard, and yeah, which strategies can you play on this map? It's like you can go for boat wizard, boat boomer. I saw some kind of sub games here too, with like ninja or something else. I don't think it's a pretty good sub-commander map, cause you don't have a good place to go for the 4-0 sub. So yeah, if you wanna go with some water towers, I think the boat wizard is pretty good here. But you can also go for, yeah, let's say wizard, ninja, heli is good here. I think DFA is also good. Yeah. So let's check how the game is running. He decided to go for a greedy 2-0 farm. So I loon boosted some pings, forced him to leak, and yeah. Leak your enemy in the early game down, let's say to 50 life, 40 life. It's some mind games, so maybe he tried to over defend later on, or boost earlier than you, or maybe he boost a small rush he shouldn't boost because he is afraid to die. So if you can go for an early life leaks, it's not bad, just for the mind games. But remember, as long as he have more than one life or more than zero life, yeah, the game is still running, so don't over rush and always care your own defense. So don't look only on his sides, look on both sides. On round 7, his defense is okay. I couldn't do anything else with greens and blacks, but round 8, both had to prepare for the grouped yellows. He dropped down his wizard, and after he sent some yellows, but I thought he couldn't have that much money, and so I didn't want to upgrade one more tower. But yeah, it's maybe I should. I leaked some life. Yeah, I think it's okay to leak some lies in this part. And if he hadn't placed his wizard before, I would definitely go for a wizard on my side, because he would have round about 800 more income to send us grouped yellows. Round 11, he tries to bait rush. So let's say it's the old strategy, you try to rush your enemy with a small tiny rush to force a boost, and if your enemy boosts, you go all out with bloom boost. So yeah, that's pretty old school strategy. As long as you don't have lightning, spike storm, damage boost, you can easy go for fast kills. So let's check his defense. It's not that big. He just upgraded with an destroyer. So I was checking, is his camo detection enough? Let's say we can go for camo ceramic and on top some pings. It's normal rush, but it wasn't that good as a rush. But he tower boost, and now he knows he have to upgrade his defense, and that was my chance to win. I just all out him. I also could go and sell all three boats and even make the rush more deadlier, but as you can see, it was enough. So let's hop into the next game. So, and our last map is Swamp. Swamp is a good Cobra map, cause you have enough room to place towers like tech or bomb. And yeah, why go tech Cobra mortar here? Well, the tech is a good early tower. You have good group popping power, and also he can easy defend here pinks and blacks. The weak part of with the tech is just LED detection and camo detection. You can go for LED detection with the ring of fire, but normally you don't want to go for the ring of fire. So in combination with a mortar, you can easy defend any rush. Let's say your enemy goes on round 13 with an all out, let's say camo rainbows, mortar has a camo detection, blade maelstrom, easy defend. He go for regrow rainbows, just blade maelstrom, easy defend. Round 15, he goes for all out leds or all out regrow leds or all out camo regrow leds. Mortar has all the detection and the blade maelstrom just finishes them all. So you're pretty safe. And for round 18, Moab, just blade maelstrom, easy defend. If he goes for round 20 in BFB and you have saved up some money and you have maybe to read your enemy, and you can go just upgrade the Cobra ability and send the BFB back. The only micro part here is if he goes for an fast cooldown all out Moab rush on round 20, so you have to save up some money before and just spam your blade maelstroms. And depends on the map, if your positioning is way hard with the blade maelstrom, you have to sell some cobras on top and just go for the mortar stall, the 2-4 ability, and yeah, just stall the Moabs and just finish them with the blade maelstroms on top. So all in all, it's a good strategy, and Swamp is a pretty good tech map. And yeah, our enemy wasn't that smart, and yeah, GG. So I hope you enjoyed. See you on the next one. Bye bye.